the skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide. Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, diminution, obligation to my nation.
Welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. Look, the Detroit Public Schools are very near and dear to my heart, so this week I am actually having a DPS back to school special. I have my good friend, Roy S. Roberts, the Emergency Financial Manager of the Detroit Public Schools, with me. Good morning, Mr. Roberts.
Good to be with you.
All right, so you got a new title.
Got a new title.
You had a lot of turmoil over the last couple weeks. So is school going to start on time?
School is going to start on time. Judge Murphy made a decision this past week that I'm responsible for the finances of this district and the school board is responsible for the academics. And the two of them come together and we have to make sure that if it's purely academic, they make the call. If it's financial, I make the call. But if it moves financials in any one way, and if we have to take that back to the judge, we can do that. And he said he would make a decision on a one-off basis. I think we'll get it done.
Okay, so who's the superintendent?
The superintendent is the new superintendent who was elected by the school board, and we're gonna respect everything that the judge said.
Wait, sir. You're telling me John Telford is the superintendent?
John Telford is the superintendent, and we're gonna accept that for what it is. And
what it is a man that wants to put Ebonics in the schools. He called the Detroit students animals.
Well, that might be his perspective, and I would hope that over time he's moved from that because we have some wonderful kids in this community.
So we fitting to have John Telford as a superintendent. Well, that's Ebonics. That's, you ever seen somebody bourgeois like me speak Ebonics?
I heard you once. Try it. But the people in this community said we want Public Act Farm. We want it gone. We want it out of here. And there are some consequences that come along with that. They elected Redford. I didn't elect him. And I'm going to work with him. The judge said I must work with him, and he and I have got to work to make sure that we get a peaceful accord in this district. The lady who was heading up academics, she will continue to do 100% of her job. Doug Ross will do 100% of his job. They will report in to him. And everybody in DPS report to me under Public Act 72. So we'll have a dual working relationship and reporting relationship, but that's not uncommon. You know, we all grew up. We reported both ways to a mother and a father. But the difference is, they both loved us.
Okay. The 15 schools that are supposed to go to the EAA, are they still going?
They're gone. It's full speed ahead. The judge made that decision that the actions that were taken did not preclude those schools from going on with their program they put in place. And that's really important because they put together an academic program that's one of the best I've ever seen. And they're going to do some great thanks for those kids who are persistently failing school. So I'm excited about that.
The plan for self-governance that you announced on our show earlier in the spring, is that still in effect?
That's still in effect. The plan is still there. There are 9 schools. Doug Ross, we got, who have managed a lot of charter schools. I got him over to manage charter schools. And then we decided if we always do what we've always done, we probably should always get what we always got. And we want to try something different. So we're trying something different where we're getting a group of really bright, capable people, even right down to a parent of a student in that school, and we're saying, you got to make the rules on what will occur. Now, they don't take the place of a board. Our board still exists at the corporate level, but they're going to run that school on a day-to-day basis to make sure we get the most out of that school. And we're going to see what that tells us. If that tells us over time that maybe we should have more schools than that, we'll see what it tells us.
So, is the Roy Roberts one-year plan that you discussed still in effect?
100% of the one-year plan is still in effect. And next week, we're going to share that full plan with the board and with the superintendent. And I hope that they see the virtue of what we've put in place and the value of it to kids in this district, and they buy into that plan. So I have reason to believe they will. If they don't, if there are changes that they want to make, if it does not impact financials, then we'll get that done. But if it impacts financials, I have to make a call.
Okay. Well, you had a lot of great plans. We're going to walk through this doorway, see if we can actually get through here without me falling. We're in a brand new McKinsey Elementary School. This is part of your plan. Tell us about this building that we've been looking at all morning.
Well, you know, the citizens in this city bought a bond program. and $500.5 million. And we built several schools. We've renovated several other schools. This is one of the new schools, McKenzie here, that we built. And we have several that look just like this, same configuration. We're now in the room where they have the library and some other factions. We just came out of the hallway, all the bright colors. These kids in this city deserve this. They deserve the best that money can buy. And that's what the citizens of this community said. And we responded. And when they come in here, they see the brightness of this school. They get a good feeling from that. We want that to be right. Then we want to make sure they get a good academic program that's going to make a difference in their lives.
Okay. Well, we're going to take a little tour of a couple of schools. We're going to go to Charles Wright over on the far west side. And then we're going to go to my alma mater, Cass Tech. I've never been in the new Cass Tech. They tell me they've taken out all the lockers that were on the second floor where so much mayhem and madness predating you was perpetrated. So, sir, I wish you luck over the next 2 weeks. Usually I'm the one starting all the mess, but I guess you got it now. You got a rough time to go.
Ball's on my court. We're going to try and get it done.
Okay. Let's hope it works, sir.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to Charles Wright. We'll be right back.
It's a new day in Detroit, and anything is possible. With an academic plan which focuses on the success of every child, the DPS Advantage puts technology in the hands of students and families. A pioneer in the 21st century, DPS provides college prep, fine arts, and medical pathways. Online portals help track student progress and attendance. Providing free healthy meals in a safe environment enables teachers to challenge our children to succeed.
It's not Detroit Public Schools. It's Detroit Public Schools.
Register your child today.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're now at the Charles H. Wright Academy on the far northwest side of Detroit. And I have Administrator Tracy Jones with us. Ms. Jones, welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. Now, Charles H. Wright is a pre-K through fourth grade school. So when school starts in a few weeks, tell us, what is a child going to experience on that first day, that most exciting day?
On the first day of school, you just said it, excitement. We here at Charles Wright are excited, enthusiastic about starting the school year. When the kids come in, we have our dedicated staff that will be ready and waiting to start instruction on that very first day. Instruction is always active. We always engage the students. We have lots of manipulatives and things that they can touch. We believe on hands-on learning. And the main thing that we want to focus on this year is individualized instruction.
Tell me a little bit more about that.
Well, through individualized instruction, in fact, you wouldn't know, we're starting a new reading program this year that really sets the tone for Charles H. Wright Academy, which is success for all. That's what we believe in. So what
will
we...
Success for all.
Success for all.
Okay.
And really, even before we began the program, that could have been our logo, because that's what we're interested in. Focusing in on where the students are, meeting them exactly where they are, then planning a program around them, and always, always focusing in on our data to make sure that we are truly addressing their individual needs and learning styles.
Now, for many parents, this will be their first experience sending their child off to school. How should they be prepared for that first day?
All right. Well, you know, here at Charles Wright, we think of our parents as partners. So once they walk in, they can feel free to relinquish their child to us. But if they really want to get set for the first day, we always like them to make sure their child gets a good night's sleep. And if they can handle those things, when they get to us, they can just expect the staff to be warm and inviting, help their child walk through the school day. We're always prepared with our lunches and breakfasts and things, so they don't have to worry about those things as well. The teacher will be there prepared with lessons. They can expect just, you know, to be able to relax and relinquish their child, put them in our hands, and enjoy their day, and know that their child is going to have a wonderful day here at Charles Wright Academy.
Okay. Tell us about the classrooms here.
Our classrooms are so inviting. They're print rich. We're bringing in more and more technology to engage the students. As you know, we also still use, we're using netbooks with our students as well.
Now, does each student get a netbook to take home, or they're too young for that?
At our school, they're a little bit too young for that, but we make sure that they have exposure. We have a wonderful media center that they can go in and experience the computer. We've brought in a lot of interactive technology pieces in terms of instruction to make sure that they are learning the new techniques as well. And then also, the teachers also use a lot of hands-on pieces that include technology into the classroom. So they're being exposed to technology as well as being exposed to hands-on instruction.
Okay, Detroit has a major problem with childhood obesity. And tell us about the outside of the school. Is there a play field?
Oh, we have a wonderful playground area, and as one of you mentioned, we had earned a Blue Cross Blue Shield grant where we also have in-house sports that we do with the teachers. Then we have, like I said, our staff is so fantastic here. They took it upon themselves to start an in-house recess. So they pick certain days, they walk through school to make sure the kids get enough exercise. Mm-hmm. We have a fantastic athletic instructor. She also makes sure that the kids, do we have house sports? How, you know about the Wii? Mm-hmm. Okay, where our kids get to go interactive. It's very much like the Wii. So at lunchtime, we engage them in activities because we don't want to be like the Obamas. We want to make sure we get our 60 minutes a day. Mm-hmm. So we get it in, we infuse it into the classroom, and we also have times during the day where we make sure they get their exercise in because we want them to get their 60 minutes in because we are concerned about obesity as well.
Now, is this one of the places where they provide free lunches?
Well, we, of course, have free lunches.
Okay.
Absolutely.
You have free lunches.
We want to make sure that our students eat well.
And they're going by the new USDA standards.
Of course.
Okay.
Of course. Everyone here at DPS, including Charles Wright, is concerned about serving our children healthy meals. So we want to make sure, again, that they have breakfast and they have lunch. Unfortunately, we don't have dinner yet, but hopefully that will come for us. But definitely, they make sure they get a balanced breakfast and lunch.
Now, do you have latchkey services here?
Yes, we do.
Okay. Tell me about that.
Well, our latchkey program, our school lets out at approximately 2:40. So once the students are dismissed, we have someone, again, very welcoming, that will take them down to our resource area, and they will stay there until their parents can pick them up till 6:30. So we're here till 6:30.
Okay. If a parent wants to enroll their child in this fabulous school, how do they do it?
We're here. We're almost 24 hours. That's how we feel.
So just stop by Steinberg Road and 7 Mile.
Exactly. Stop by our office. Our secretary will be waiting, and we've got paperwork, packets, all set.
You know, many of our police officers are now on 12-hour shifts. That's why I asked about the latchkey. A lot of them are concerned about that day shift, finding some place for their child to be 12 hours. That's hard for that. But this gives the working parent something to do. Is there anything you want to add about Charles H. Wright?
I could just go on and on about Charles Wright, but I really love the fact that we're bringing in more and more community partners. We had our kids, DPS has cut down on some of the extracurriculars, but through our community partners, we were able to have art instruction here. We have Tappers, Mercedes-Benz is also partnering with us, that they bring in helpers. And we have online a few more community partners that we want to add in that we come in to mentor the students in terms of reading. We also had the Reading Corps volunteers that came in as well. Okay. So there's tons and tons of things going on here at Charles Wright, and we have more that we anticipate coming. So we have a host of activities for the students.
Ms. Jones, you're a product of DPS?
Oh, absolutely.
Cass Tech, I believe.
Yes, you know.
That's right. Well, we're going to Cass Tech next. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to visit Cass. We'll be right back.
It's a new day in Detroit, and anything is possible. With an academic plan which focuses on the success of every child, the DPS Advantage puts technology in the hands of students and families. A pioneer in the 21st century, DPS provides college prep, fine arts, and medical pathways. Online portals help track student progress and attendance. Providing free healthy meals in a safe environment enables teachers to challenge our children to succeed.
It's not Detroit Public Schools. It's Detroit Public Schools.
Register your child today.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're at our final stop of our whirlwind tour of DPS, getting you ready to go back to school. We're at my alma mater, or what used to be my alma mater, Cass Tech. And this is Assistant Principal
Verinda Strotter.
First of all, Cass Tech is still a test into school.
Absolutely. Examination High School.
Okay, so for those 7th and 8th graders that want to try and get into these hallowed halls to this awesome educational experience, what do they have to do?
Those students need to work hard, they need to study, they need to prepare English, math, science, social studies, and get themselves ready to test into the school.
So they get themselves ready to test into the school. What can they experience here? Tell me about the first day of a freshman at Cass Tech.
Well, we've got over 2,300 students at this school, and the first day for a freshman could be overwhelming. Mm-hmm. But that first day they come into these halls, they are jam-packed with students who are ready, and they are determined to do what they are supposed to do in the classroom. And what they do when they get here is they will be welcomed. They will start off on that first day of school in classroom with lots of work to do, and they will definitely be successful.
They will definitely be successful. Mm-hmm. Okay. When will they choose their curriculum? You guys are still curriculum-based. That hasn't changed. You took my locker out, but that hasn't changed. You're still curriculum-based, right?
We are still curriculum-based, yes. Right. We do have seven main curriculums.
What are they?
We've got human services, mm-hmm. Bio, which is chemical and biological.
Thank God you didn't get rid of that.
We didn't get rid of that. We have science and arts.
Okay.
We have arts, communications, mm-hmm. music, performing arts, mm-hmm. and engineering.
And engineering. Mm-hmm. So those aren't tested into, but the kids choose their curriculum track.
That's right. When they take the test through the district, they are able to choose when they do our application which curriculum, and they rate them 1, 2, mm-hmm. and 3. And when the curriculum is full, then we move them to their second choice.
Okay, tell me about your labs. The science labs here were famous. In fact, I actually learned how to calculate the critical mass of a thermonuclear weapon at Cass Tech in 1981. So don't put me on the terror watch list. tell me about your labs here now.
We still do have state-of-the-art labs. We also do have a garden area that it does change climates. Mm-hmm. If they want to study the desert, they can do that. If they want it to be a Mediterranean, they can do that, and it does change. But we do still have our state-of-the-art science labs.
You have a garden area that changes flora and fauna, or...?
You can control the temperature.
Okay.
If you want it to be desert-like, if you want it to be more Mediterranean, if you mm-hmm. want it to be, and they can control and grow whatever type of plant that they want to grow in there.
Cass Tech was known for its arts. Mm-hmm. Tell me about that. Do you still have a major symphony here, or what do you have?
We definitely still have our music curriculum. We have our orchestra still. We have a famous marching band. Mm-hmm. We still do our vocal performances. Mm-hmm. We still have harp and vocal. Mm-hmm. So students can learn how to play the harp, or if they are still playing the harp, they can still come here. Our music curriculum is either instrumental or vocal.
Okay. Tell me about extracurricular activities, non-sports related.
Non-sports related. We have anything just about that you can think of mm-hmm. That you're interested in, we have it here at Cass Tech. We've got Japanese anime. We've got art, different art mm-hmm. organizations. We have the Red Cross. We have National Honor Society. Mm-hmm. We have some of everything. Anything that a student wants to do, we definitely have that as an opportunity for them. Mm-hmm. And if they don't have it, they just have to find a sponsor, and we are happy to join and add more organizations.
Tell me about this International Baccalaureate program.
Absolutely.
What is that all about?
International Baccalaureate is a separate curriculum that we have been, and we're very fortunate and we're very excited about it, mm-hmm. that we are now an international and IB school. That means that we have applied and we are in the second phase of being an IB school, which means within the next year we will definitely have all of those IB curriculums. And what that means is it's separate from AP, and everyone is familiar with advanced placement.
Right.
But IB is a global degree, and they mm-hmm. get a separate degree that says that they are globally aware. They have separate classes that is on a different tier than the AP classes.
Mm-hmm.
Not many schools actually in the state are IB certified, mm-hmm. But you've got to go through the application process. You have to apply. You have to be accepted. Your school has to have certain characteristics in order for it to be, and we are a very good example of an IB school because of our curriculums kind of help in that whole process as well.
Okay. Last base. Mm-hmm. I mean, we talk about computers.
Uh-huh.
Now, does every child here get a netbook to take home, or what goes on here?
That is a district initiative, and last year, actually, we were the pilot school for sending mm-hmm. students home with laptops. Mm-hmm. So our students were able to have a laptop and take out. And this school year, all students are going to be able to have a laptop that will be theirs that they will sign out. And we've got carts and carts of laptops here on site.
Ready for those freshmen.
Ready for those freshmen.
Ready for those first
Absolutely.
Day of school. Okay, finally, we've talked uh-huh. about academics. We've talked about how to get in here. You've also got sports here.
Absolutely.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Everything but football, because we're going to, you know, I'm actually going to talk to Coach Wilcher, Mr. Superstar,
uh-huh.
and young Jayru.
That's right.
When this is over. But mm-hmm. what sports do you offer here?
We offer everything from, of course, you mentioned football. We've got girls and boys basketball. We have girls volleyball. We have cross country, girls and boys track and field. We have soccer. We have baseball and softball. We have tennis. We have golf. We have, what have I missed? Did I miss anything? We have everything except for wrestling.
That's good. Okay. Well, Madam Assistant Principal, I want to thank you for
Absolutely.
This whirlwind tour of CAS. Ladies and gentlemen, when we get back, it's Coach Wilcher and Jayru Campbell, the phenom.
It's a new day in Detroit, and anything is possible. With an academic plan which focuses on the success of every child, the DPS Advantage puts technology in the hands of students and families. A pioneer in the 21st century, DPS provides college prep, fine arts, and medical pathways. Online portals help track student progress and attendance. Providing free healthy meals in a safe environment enables teachers to challenge our children to succeed.
It's not Detroit Public Schools, it's Detroit Public Schools.
Register your child today.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. For our last segment, we're going to talk about sports. We can't talk about sports without talking about the state champions, Class A, Cass Tech, and their coach. First of all, Thomas Wilcher, great job.
Thank you very much.
And then we've got the 14-year-old phenom, Jayru Campbell. Yeah. Okay, you were stunning in the championship game. Coach, we've seen news story after news story about bad kids. You've got a bunch of youngsters here that you marshaled into a team. You worked hard, you worked through adversity. Tell us, how do you reach these kids?
You got to reach them one at a time and give them examples with other young men, so then therefore you can get them to working together. So peer mentoring is one key role, and just keep reinforcing the good things kids are doing, and keep bringing up the bad things they're doing so you can't forget. That's all. Just reinforcement, peer mentoring, and just keep on staying on top of them, really.
Last year, during the championship game, on the way to the championship, your team marched from Cass Tech to Ford Field. What was that all about? Was that just a mind game on everybody else? Or were you all just showing your superior conditioning that you'd walk 5 miles and then go win?
No, it wasn't quite five miles.
It always seems like five when I did it.
But the walk was just to get the kids focused, and which it did. It got them focused, it got them ready to go, and it got them excited about being there. And so I reached my goal. And the best part about the game to me and to the kids when they really got excited was the walk. Leaving Cass Tech, walking straight down that street and making that right-hand turn into the stadium, I think it was probably one of the best things I did. And probably one of the best things the kids wanted to do the previous year. And I just kept it going.
Okay. Jayru, you're 14 years old now?
15.
You're 15 years old.
Yes.
How do you handle the pressure? How do you keep going?
What I do is I just always remember that I'm not where I want to be at. And, you know, I still want to get better and better, you know, and achieve some more goals.
Okay. Did your formative years have to do anything with your level head?
This is my year starting last year. You know, I played PAL and I didn't start. So we still won the championship, but this is the year that, you know, I had to step in and, you know, start and take
the job. I'm talking about your formative years, though. When you were growing up, when you were a little boy, what did it have to do with your level-headedness right now?
Well, growing up, I always played quarterback, and you know, we won. You know, I won a lot. You know, for the Westside Steelers, you know, my pal team. So, you know, my dad, my mom, you know, always stayed on me. You know, stay level-headed. You know, don't get too cocky. You know, stay humble. So, it had a big part to do with my parents.
And what did your grandfather, my personal trainer, have to do with all this?
He stuck with me. I worked out with him, you know. He just always wanted the best for me, you know. We had a bunch of talks, you know, here and there. He just always wanted the best for me.
Okay. Well, you have an extremely level head. I want you to know you keep getting a lot of hits on our YouTube channel when I just mentioned your name. People look you up all over the world. Side for 10 great things. Coach, you guys gonna take the championship this year?
That's our goal. That's what we're focused on. I'm on the guys. I'm trying to get team camaraderie.
All right.
I'm trying to build team brotherhood. We're trying to build a family atmosphere out there. And most important, we're trying to create some team competition so we can always keep rising our level up.
Okay. Jayru, you gonna take it home?
Oh yeah. You know, we're gonna get a repeat, and hopefully after that, another one, and hopefully after another one.
Okay. Hey, you're a good basketball player, too. We'll talk about that another day.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching our DPS Back to School special. Don't forget, this week is DPS Week. It's a parade. Everything, you can go to the DPS website and look it up, join it, and remember, your public schools are your public schools, and you've seen the greatness of it today. Have a great week.